Hey programmers, let's dig into the DMX sheet today. This is our real-time DMX output. It's exactly what we're sending to the rig. And beyond being a great feedback tool, it also has DMX testing capabilities, both out and in. Welcome back to Consoletrainer. I'm Kat. You can like or subscribe, you know the drill. And if you have questions, leave them in the comments. The DMX sheet shows every channel by its universe and what its current output value is. This is the information that our lighting rig is getting right now, and it's always updating with any cues you play or any changes you make in your programmer. The cells with the darker background are channels that aren't patched. Like most sheets, there's a bunch of options to sort this window and make it easier to use. Starting with our options window, under Tools, if you want to change this window to show absolute addresses, you can find that option here. An option that I think is a must change is under display. I want to change the readout to decimal. That will show me the real DMX values between 0 and 255, not just a percentage. A lot of the other options in here are also found in the top title bar. First off, turning on programmer colors is a fast way to show any values we're affecting in the programmer in red. The next dropdown can add things like fixture IDs and attributes, and the Show Address option puts the actual address of value at the top of each cell, so you don't have to reference the guides at the top and the left of the screen. If you want to keep it simple and leave this on Show Only Values, you can always click on a cell and see the address, ID, and attribute at the bottom of the screen. I love Only Selected when I need to check the DMX output of a light in my rig and not have to look up the address first. With this on, the screen will scroll me right to the universe of that fixture. The next couple of options are for the built-in DMX tester. This means that we can send any value to any channel at any time, right from this sheet. If Link Encoders is on, then when you touch a cell in the sheet, it will put that channel on your encoders, allowing you to affect the output of that channel directly. This isn't the same as putting attributes in the fixture sheet. Anything you do with this tester is going to override anything else your console might have in the programmer or playback. Also, if you try to clear out, that value is not going to go away. But clicking Release All will release any edits you've made by the tester. Imagine that you're trying to find a dimmer in a universe, but you don't know what its address is. If you set the first channel to full, or 255, you can then just roll the address wheel until the light turns on. You can see that 255 value rolling over the channels one at a time. This works because the release option is on for address. If we switch to retain, then as we roll, we leave all the previous channels at full as well. The first option above the wheels determines what channels we're allowed to test, all or just the patched or the unpatched channels. The select all button will select all the channels we have test values on and also put them all at the value we last set on the test output. The next options are to be more specific about what you want to release. You already know release all, but you can also choose to release just the channels you're currently working with or just the channels you're testing that you don't currently have selected. And you can also park or unpark DMX channels right from this toolbar. And here's a neat trick that I've seen some other programmers do. They'll park the last channel of their universe to be the same value as the number of that universe. That way, when their techs are doing DMX testing, they can take a look at their reader, look at the last channel, and confirm that they're looking at the right universe. Now, obviously, this only works if you don't have any real-life lights patched all the way through 512, but more often than not, it works out. You aren't limited to just clicking in this screen and rolling the encoders. You can key in your values. Hitting the channel key twice will put the DMX keyword on your command line. From there, you can type in a range by specifying the universe, dot the channel numbers, and then you could say at and a value. Alternatively, with the DMX channel selected, you can still use the wheel. If you want to use the command line to release DMX values, then use the off keyword along with the universe number and channels. Typing off DMX through please without specifying any numbers would essentially be a release all. I kind of skipped over this last encoder because it doesn't have much to do with our DMX testing scenario, but what it does is it allows you to pick a channel within the sheet, and then from the pop-up menu, we could pick any unit and make that selected DMX channel the start address for it. That was our DMX output tester. Now let's talk about DMX input testing. If you want to set up your grandMA2 as the world's most expensive DMX tester, you can. You could plug any DMX universe into the DMX in on the back and then configure that port for an empty universe. And by the way, if you have a turnaround adapter, any port on the console can be turned into a DMX in. Now, if we take a look at that universe in the DMX sheet, we've got the same values that I'm outputting on universe 1 showing up in this empty universe. This could be handy if you feel like there's an issue with a cable or something else happening outside of the MA. And because we have options to bring ArtNet and SACN into the console as well, you could use that same idea to set either of those inputs to start at an empty universe for viewing. And changing the amount will show you multiple universes. After you configure your second line, make sure that you've also set your input option to active. Now you're an expert in all things DMX sheets and testing on the MA2. Hopefully this will be helpful in your future gigs. If you want to help support the channel so I can keep making more videos, you can become a member of my crew over at the Consoletrainer Patreon page. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.